Hello everybody, welcome back to the Midlands Outdoors channel today, back with another episode, which this one is going to be pretty much really interesting really, because I am going to be covering the Hagley or the state, going over a bit of history which is currently on Wychbury Hill, and obviously making my way all the way down the back, down the bottom down there to go to Hagley Hall itself. It is a nice walk, so if you want some ideas as well, this is pretty much one that I really love to do, because you can obviously get to Hagley Hall if you on Wychbury Hill. You can obviously cross down where the monument is and go right down the back. There's like a path that leads down the bottom you can cross over, and there's like a road that goes down the back of Hagley Hall, so we might see if we can cover down there, but I might come back the way I come, because I do know it's pretty much really muddy down the back. So I hope you enjoyed the video, and let's get up to the monument. Yeah, I mean, Wychbury Hill though is pretty much a really popular place, because you do obviously get your visitors up here through the monument, which is situated right off the back in a little bit. But just look at the views though, I mean, it's just absolutely spectacular and amazing. Just see the views right in the distance. You've got the Malverns over there, distance that I can see. Beautiful morning in the distance with all the fog just lingering right in the depths over there. I don't know if I had to pick it up, see that. And we have got the Temple of Ephesus down there. We're heading down there a bit later on, towards when we get into the parts of Hagley Hall. I can see Hagley Hall just right from here. I can obviously see the hall, really massive in size from a distance, but getting up close, you will see shots of that after when I take some nice photographs and look at the St. John's Church, which is obviously in the grounds as well. But wow, it's just lovely to just come out and see the view this morning. Again, parts of Hagley right down the distance down there. Got Lower Hagley and the Hagley at the top, just right down the bottom down here. Wow. So yeah, just right behind me right now, so there is quite a bit of history behind this. So obviously says the obelisk is a grade 2 listed building. It is 84 feet 26 meters high and could be seen for about many miles as far as Shropshire and the hill, if not the monument on its summit from the Malverns, which is right the way over in the distance where I showed you over there earlier. It was commissioned as a family memorial and completed in 1758 at the same time as Hagley Park was being redeveloped in the fashionable neoclassical style. So obviously we've, even apart from this, we have got a bit of the history with the old Temple of Ephesus that is right down the bottom. If you just look at this sheet that I've got for you today, if I just scroll over onto the other page, bear me 1 second, I have got some photos of the Wychbury monument. I don't know if you had to see that. I am going to put the photos on to show you as well, a bit clear, but you can obviously there the monument is actually being redone up. and you've got all that stuff that's surrounded, like the scaffolding, like the base at the bottom covering where it was actually badly collapsing, and you can see there like the sketch of the monument itself. So I'm gonna pop the photos on now for you just to show you that. Again, it is pretty really interesting just to see the old photos there, have it being redone up on that sketch. So let's go and take a look at the Temple of Theseus, which is right the way down the bottom. So here we are, this is actually the Temple of Theseus, which is sitting on Wychbury Hill at the moment, and it is again a grade listed building, and I'll go over a bit of history in a bit for you. But you can just see, look at the architecture of it though, it's just amazing just to see this. And I know it has been restored quite a few times, I know the roof inside it has been restored, but it is again, it's a shame though, because it is in quite a really bad state at the moment, because we've got all the graffiti which is on the sides of the Temple of Theseus. It never actually used to be there at one point, but I know there's graffiti inside it that used to be there all the time. Well, if we just take a look around the front of it, it is again amazing just to see this. And again, you can just see, look at that. The architecture is just absolutely amazing. I mean, just to see a place like this though, I mean, the architecture, the pillars going down, the roof as well, which is onto it, it's just cool. But let's have a look at the history and I'll tell you more about the Temple of Theseus, because there is a bit here about it for you. So yeah, we have got some information on the Temple of Theseus, so I will actually tell you a bit about it now. So it is, again, it says the Doric Temple of 1758, designed by James Athenian Stuart. It stands in the Grade 1 Register Park and Garden, 800 metres north of Hagley Hall. It is separated from the rest of the estate by the A456. This relatively isolated location has rendered its vulnerability to vandalism, so security fencing has been erected around the little part just around here, which you can see people have been getting under it. I have come up here the once and I have seen people in the Temple of Theseus, and also for walking from the road down the bottom, when realistically there shouldn't be nowhere near the temple itself, to be fair, because it's obviously grade listed and it isn't very safe, because I noticed the roof as well inside that could give way any time, and I know they've done repairs to it over numerous times. But Temple Foley, 1758, by James Athenian Stuart for George First Lord Littleton, restored and partly rebuilt late C20, sandstone ashlar and brick with shallow pitch roof of coated steel, rectangular planning form of the miniature replica of a Greek Doric hexastyle prostyle temple, having arist voluti columns with antasis and no bases, replica of the C6 BC Theseian in Athens. It was designed by Stuart shortly after he visited Athens from 1751 to measure the buildings. It is earliest C18 building to have been directly copied from an ancient Greek original, and is the first building outside Greece and colonies in which the Greek Doric order is correctly used. The columns and much of the sandstone work were rebuilt in C20. So yeah, on the history, I did make a mistake. I said sandstone work when it was actually stonework. But to me, it actually does look like kind of sandstone. That's what made me actually say it, because if you look at the walls, you can obviously see the decay of the side where it's been scraped. And now sandstone usually erodes like that. And if you can just see here as well, a majority of it does actually look like sandstone. It's making our way to Hagley or the state. It's literally just over the road over there. It's not actually too far. And then we're going to be rejoining from there and have a look at the old church, which is situated there. But before we do that, I've got a bit of information just to discuss with you one more on the Hagley or the state before we head over to there. So as you can see, I've been doing quite a lot of research on Hagley. This is why I've sat down to tell you about it, because this is actually the family history of the hall itself. So what I'm going to do is tell you a bit about it, so give you a gist about what the family was all about, what Hagley Hall was. So let's start with this bit here, because it actually says the Littletons had been established in Worcestershire for several centuries, when in 1564 Sir John knighted at Kenilworth by Elizabeth I. bought the Aglioal estate through his maternal descent from John of Gaunt, the family were entitled to a quarter of the royal arms with their own. Sir John's grandson died in the Tower in 1601 for his part in the Essex Rebellion, and his widow, Meriel, was the first to make Hagley her principal home. Their son, Thomas, was created a baronet in 1618 and was responsible for the raising the royalist forces in Worcestershire. Indeed, his son Charles fled into exile with Charles II. Sir Charles's son, Thomas, married Christian Temple of Stow, a lady waiting to Queen Anne, and through her Cobham title, family came to the Littletons. Their son, George, 1st Baron Littleton, before embarking on the building of his new house, was private secretary to Frederick, Prince of Wales, eldest son of George II, and later became Chancellor of the Exchequer in 1754. So, more information now. Thomas, eldest son of George, was a fine scholar, orator, and before his father's death, Member of Parliament, known to the family as Naughty Tom. He is reputed to have gambled Hagley against Pitcher of the Messrs. He spent much of his time at Arley Castle at Upper Arley with his sister Lucy, Lady Valentia, but lived in Epsom, where he died without issues in his late 30s. The title was recreated for his uncle, William Henry, Lord Westcote, who among his opponents was Governor of Jamaica and South Carolina. His second son, William Henry, married Lady Sarah Spencer, who widowed young Rose to become governess to Queen Victoria's children. Her son, George, married Mary Glynne at the same ceremony in 1839 as a sister. Catherine married William Gladstone. So you can see a bit of that family history relating to the family that lived around in the Hagleyard estate. Lord Littleton was responsible for the founding of the Canterbury settlement in New Zealand. His family of 15 children, 12 by Mary Glynne and 3 by Sibella Clive, themselves became famous as cricketers, statesmen, soldiers and bishops. Gained some nice interesting more history there, which I've actually learnt more about. So we've actually got some of the hall history, which I will show you a photo of what Hagleyard actually looks like, which you can just see in the photo there. Look at the estate itself inside. It's got a nice architecture on the ceiling. All the photos, redevelopment from that itself, I will tell you a bit more later, but this actually sat on fire, so it's not actually all the original stuff that was in Hagleyard. I'll show you what it actually used to look like, surprisingly enough. So the manor of the Hagley still belongs to the Littleton family, whose head is Viscount Cobham. The family still live at Hagleyard, a listed building standing in Grade 1 landscape parkland. This was landscaped in the 1750s when the head of family was a leading politician. Features of the landscaping include the monument or obelisk of Wychbury Hill, which can be seen for many miles around, Hagley Castle, a foley, which is over there right in the distance, just by where Clent Hills, as you go right to the top. And the Temple of Theseus, which is behind me, beside the A456. The hall is in Palladian style, designed by Sanderson Miller. It was rebuilt after suffering a disastrous fire in 1925. Well, so it actually tells you about a fire that happened in 1925. Right, just moving right over now for you. I will just put that piece of paper aside. But you can see, look at these old photos of Hagleyard itself. You can see a photo there with all members back in the days. Again, you can just see there that the table, what's in there with all photos. I think that's what your covenant is in like now. So if you do manage to pay and go around, you will see pretty much of the designs of Hagleyard itself. Let's take a look at the next page. And you can see there is actually the fire that happened in 1925. And you can see what the Hagleyard really looks like. Look at that. It was pretty much in a really bad sort of like derelict state when it actually sat on fire. So it was left for quite a bit of time before they actually managed to restore it into the state it was then, which you can see in the photo. Look at what Hagleyard actually looks like. It's pretty crazy just to see what it actually looked like there compared to there when it was really much in a bad state. So again, history, it's crazy just to learn about how far it dates back and what actually happened to the place. If many of you never know, Hagleyard sat on fire, then you definitely knew in this video what pretty much really happened. So there is pretty much really more history onto the Hagley Hall itself, and you're going to see here. So I will read you this one. So the principal building, Hagley Hall, listed grade one, was rebuilt from 1754 on a site southwest of the Hold House, whose position in late C20 was occupied by the cricket pitch. Sir George Littleton considered various proposals, although the final design was by Sanderson Miller in 1716-80. It was something of a hybrid of a Palladian rectangle of two stories, raised upon a rusticated basement that contains the office's pavilion-like projections at four corners, rise one story higher than the rest of the building. The building of Hagley is exuberant. Rococo interior decoration was completed in 1760. The house was badly damaged by the fire in 1925, although subsequently meticulous, I think that word there, restored. So again, pretty much more information and history there, so I will quickly show you a bit there if you can just read it, and if you pause the video you can obviously read that, but we won't go too much over it because again there is quite a lot, and we've even still got more to cover with the church, which again is in the Hagley Hall estate itself. Pretty interesting. I will show you inside that a bit later on. So yeah, let's make our way now to Hagley Hall, although covering most of the history on the estate and all the stuff behind me. So here we are, we've actually made it to Hagley Hall, which is only literally just around that corner. But you can see as well, I believe this is actually part of Hagley Hall as well. I mean, these are like offices and like a little office site for different businesses. But many, many years ago, you just imagine all this being part of the estate as well. And again, like I mentioned at the start of the video, how it had linking into Wychbury Hill. So it would have been pretty much big land, the Hagley Hall estate would have covered the majority of the area. But again, just looking at them as well, those offices, you can just see how old they are by the roof, by the brick walls as well, and how it's designed. Pretty much really interesting. So yeah, this is it. So you can see, just looking at Hagley Hall just coming through, look at the architecture of it. Again, it is a really, really big building. You can obviously go around the side to get to it as well. But just looking at it though, it's just wow. Just imagine what the original building would have looked like. Especially after it sat on fire as well, and before that. I will place that photo back on for you now, where you can see the building sat on fire. If I just go around, just keeping that image on still so you can just take it in. Now compare it to the front. I don't know whether there's any changes from when they redeveloped the hall back into its original state. Let's have a quick look actually, it'd be really interesting to find out. So it's looking from this side. Wait one second. You get a better view from here, look at that. So again, you can just see the Hagley all from there. And you see like the top lot little bits here and how it's designed. Really, really interesting. But you can obviously book tours to go in there as well. It doesn't really cost much at all. I think it's about £12 just to go around the second floor, what's into there. I did go and inquire about it, but it's got like all the furniture in there, how it would have looked. But the picture where the staircase is actually at the front of the hall. We're at the right back of it. Now, you can obviously get around there, but obviously I'm not going to go around it because I think you can only go around it if you're going for like a little tour. But it's coming down though, we've even got more history. We've got the big lands as well, which surround the estate. Look at these. It's a really, really big estate altogether. Got obelisks right in the distance over there. Some grade listed buildings as well on here. But what's fascinating, why I do love coming to Hagley Hall, is you have got deers, and I'm part of the estate for many, many years. And the Hagley Woods as well, but I haven't seen them for quite a long time. But I don't know if you'd be able to spot them, but them right in the distance in the gap over there. I will see if there's any on the other side a bit later. But there's really loads of them on the estate. And it's nice if you've got a zoom camera to try and spot them as well. But yeah, it's getting some more cinematics to the side. Look at this. Again, all around the sides, look. So you can get a better view of it. If you are interested in coming to do the tour, the best way to do it is you can come at 1 p.m. I believe. If you just go around there, you can have this, obviously a door you can ring. You just ring the door and they'll come out to you and then you can go in. I am going to do it. I'm thinking about going around there. I'm not too sure whether you can film or take pictures. I haven't inquired about it, but I actually might do. The next time I visit, I might see if I can do like a bit of picture work around there to show you, maybe in a future video soon. But what's interesting about Hagley Hall Estate is the old church, which is situated on the land, and we are going to go and take a look just inside, and we'll show you the architecture as well inside the church, hoping that this is open at the moment. You can just see, just look at the architecture of this sort of wood stock support thing going right the way to the top. It is similar to St. Canal's Church, where you walk in, you've got those walking gates to go right way into the church. And you've got that writing just right at the top up there, look. It's nice to see like the patterned architecture which has been placed into the wood. If I just go through this, there is obviously the graves as well. You've got the graves for the Littletons, which were obviously buried onto the site here. Trying to think which ones it was. I do believe it was the section here where the Littleton family for Hagley Hall was buried. I think it was that one there. Now I can see, I don't really want to tread over there really, but you can see George William, Lord Littleton, 1876, and it's the one where I'm pointing right there. And again, there's more Littletons. I can see one there. I don't know whether it's Lavinia. I don't know if it's Lavinia. I don't know, because it's sort of covering by moss. Littleton, and it's got a date on there again. I can't really see the date. It says Caroline, and there's more Littletons, William, something Littleton. Pretty, really interesting. I will show you just in the church. There is, if we can get into there again, there is like little plaques on the wall showing you a bit of stuff. So yeah, it is pretty much a really interesting place, because you can obviously look at the architecture of the walls up there. Like these little columns going up and down. Look at these here. Again, I think it is a grade listed place as well. It does tell you a majority of the history on this leaflet, so I will mention it to you. Evidence from the Domesday Book suggests that they were likely to have been a church here since the Saxon times, probably constructed of timber, wattle, daub and thatch, maybe on this site or nearby. It says there, the village known as Haglia, from the 12th to the 14th century, the D. Hagley family were the lords of the manor, and such responsible for the provision of the church. It dates there 1100s, and again, some more dates there. So you can see a picture there. I don't know if you had to see it like a very clearly. He stays on that church in the 19th century, getting some old photos. And there is information about that little window, is what I mean, the stained glass windows. And if I can just open up, it actually says the turret and the spire. So these were not built until 1865, after sufficient money had been collected to build it. It was many more years before a pearl of 8 bells was installed in the tower in 1885, dedicated to the memory of the late Rector W.H. Littleton, Rector from 1847 and 1885. By this time, the population of Lower Hagley, as it was originally called, had much increased after the coming of a railway line in 1852. A mission church hall was opened in 1882. In 1908, a substantial stone church was erected in the village and dedicated to St. Saviour. Again, there was that further improvements here. So it said the 20th century, in 1924, the Lady Chapel was refurnished to the Lady Cobham in memory of her husband, due to 1922. The old gas lighting was replaced by electricity in 1933. However, by 1979, the building was in considerable need of repair and was threatened with closure. Again, if I just look a bit further on this guide here, you will see like there's a map on here, which you can see. And there is more interesting things, which you can see there, the Lady Chapel. I believe that is actually right the way of the back over there. I'll go and take a look in a bit. And it actually says, the Lady Chapel was created through gift of Mary Dowager, Lady Cobham, in memory of her husband Charles Littleton, 8th Viscount Cobham, 1843 to 1922. He was the first of the Littleton family to bear the title of Viscount Cobham. The chapel was dedicated in October 1924. So we could say the east windows, which I'll see where that one actually is, east window. Just looking at that one, I will try and find it a bit later. But it says this great window was installed in 1900 and given by Lady Frederick Cavendish, Lucy Littleton and the Hon. Spencer Littleton was dedicated to the memory of their mother Mary, who passed away in 1857. This window was designed by Charles Kemp and replaced earlier window, as the Parish Magazine commented, December 1900. Again, there is 1800 dates on here. It's there's loads of dating right the way back. Yeah, this is actually the stained glass windows which are in the Hagley Church. They are interesting because look at the architecture and the way they're built, and I believe the dates, I'm dating way back a bit on these. I've got an information leaflet just on the corner to show you later. But it just says 1917 of Hagley House there. It's got like more families there, look on the side, it's got family members at the bottom. Again, there is more interesting other ones. You've got these ones here. It says there, William Cobham Gibbs, 1884 to 1903, and he died on the 8th of March 1918. Again, look at the style of that though, it's just absolutely amazing. Look at that. And I believe as well there is more like interesting history. If we just take a look around here, there is like more, this stuff on the Littletons. We've got George Lord Littleton, and it obviously states there he died on the 24th, 1773, in August, age 64. There's more here about more Littletons, John Littleton, and Mariel Littleton. And you've got Thomas Lord Littleton right at the top, 27th of November, 1779, aged 35. So it was a few years after George Littleton when he passed. Quite a lot of interesting information on the church telling you about the family that lived in the Hagley Hall, which is only just over the road, over the corner. But there is stunning architecture here. We've even got a bell tower up there, look. We've got this like, little bell thing which you can pull. And again, there is like the little doorway system here leading up to there, so I believe, because it is locked, there is stairs leading up to the top of that and going right to the top of there. But look at the view and the light coming through there, though, it's absolutely stunning. If I just go back a bit, look at that. Wow. Just walking down now, so we've got the big light pews in the middle. But just walking down, look at the ceiling.
I mean, those, I think those are dating back quite a bit as well. Look at those. But again, there is like more interesting little things on here. So we've got them glass windows at the back. But just walking up to here, look at the architecture of this one though. I mean, we've got the red carpet onto here. Again, the stained glass windows into that one, especially that one with that like candle and that light just hanging from the ceiling. Look at that. Absolutely really interesting just to see this. And again, look at the chair. That chair that's right the way at the bottom. Absolutely stunning just to see that. It is really interesting again. So let's have a look in there, have a look at a bit of history and show you the architecture, which is again on the roof. And you can see, if I just look out to it, and again the old architecture on the sides, look, and the big point sticking all the way up. So that's where that little inway went, where that door which was locked, it actually went up to the top, up to there. So let's have a look around the corner. I mean, you can just see how old the graves are all together. I mean, it's like moss growing on this one. It's obviously again made of sandstone, which is eroding quite really bad. Again, the writing just fading away, probably dating back to the late 1800s, 1700s. The majority of these on here as well, which you can see, again dating to the Littleton families, relatives. Look how old these ones are. Again, sandstone ones, which are really old. 1700 on there, and look at the names are faded away. You can get similar vibes to this as well if you do go and pop to the it's up Romsley, trying to think of the name of it again, St Canal's Church. If you go there, you will get some old vibes of old graves dating back to the late 1800s. Nice church to go and take a look at the architecture. So if you've never seen that one, I do recommend to go and check it out. If I was you, it's really fascinating to go and take a look at. So you can see now I've come to the back of the church. Look at the architecture from the back of it. You can obviously get a better view of the bell tower as well from the back, look. And this side here, it does again, it obviously reminds me of St Canal's Church quite a lot. And then you've got the back areas, but St Canal's Church is a bit more smaller, and it has a smaller like bell tower in there. It's in smaller of a design, but you can tell how old it is as well, similar to the St Canal's, how old the brickwork is as well on the sides. You can just imagine there probably has been repairs to this over many years. But there's the Hagley old estate again, just over in the distance. But you can obviously walk a majority of this land. I do believe there is paths at the back as well. That there goes in a direct line to the Clent Hill side, which is, if you go by Clent Hills, you've got the private section that's going right the way where the castle is, the Castle Foley. That all belongs to this land and is quite decent, big in size. But the deers, they could be anywhere, but they tend to more be on this section down by the Aglord itself. It'd be amazing if we could get a bit close though. I'm just going to have a quick walk around and see if we can get a better view for you. I don't know whether the Scarpa will go. Look at these, very close up. I don't know, I'll be able to get some close shots and get some nice photography. But when I'm walking, you can see the deers. There's loads of them. I mean, it's just close to get to deers. I mean, you can spot them as well if you go to the wire forest. You can see loads of deers. It's not every day you see deers really, and especially up close. But there's a lovely albino one as well, a white one. I have seen an albino one in the wild in Wye Forest, and to see it is just absolutely amazing. So I don't know if I'd be able to see them, but if I look a bit close, look at this. There is loads of them, look. You can see the white one walking off. Wow, there's just loads lying down. So yeah, this is pretty much it for the estate. I may come back down in the future and we will take a tour around Hagley Hall. If you would like that, feel free to drop it in the comments as well. I'll try and get it arranged if possible. But for now, that is pretty much it for today. We've covered again history of the Wychbury Hill, history of the church, history of the Hagley Hall. Again, a little bit like a Temple of Theseus as well, pretty interesting. If you have enjoyed it, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. I mean, I've took my day out for this video and I've enjoyed it all so far. Just at least going to that church and taking a look. You know, it's something that I wanted to do today, so I was hoping for it to be really quiet. Again, it's just spectacular just to see the deers, and I'm not even afraid. They're not even walking off and they can hear me. There's loads over there though, it's tons. But yeah, I'm heading home now, it's gone freezing. And yeah, stay subscribed as well, more videos upcoming. See you soon.